Okay, guys, so I'm just going to share my screen with you all. Okay, so you can go through, you can just follow what I am going to do and do the same on your Jupyter notebook. Okay. Okay. Shantan?
Yes, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes. You are audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Open
Yes,
your
ma'am.
phone.
Okay.
Okay. And do the same what I am doing.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Okay, guys, last day we did a function which takes variable length of parameters. Okay, that is any number of values can be passed inside a function. Okay. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so just I'm doing. It was like that, no?
Ma'am, yesterday, means the previous class, we have done variable length arguments using args and k-args. This
Yes.
was the last topic which we had done.
And also
So,
I used one variable names and print the names. Remember?
ma'am, can you repeat it once again?
I'm just showing you. Okay. We can do this now. We can pass the name underscore list as argument to my underscore names. And if I want to pass any number of items, okay, then I can put the names, I can write the names separated by commas and add the names within the function my underscore names. Okay. Then this function calls this my underscore names. Okay. and get executed, print the names out here, okay? So I can pass any number of variables. So one thing I want to show you right now, that is if I want to do some sort of addition, okay? So just I'm doing. Just wait.
Ma'am, your screen is not visible.
Yes, I am facing some network issues. Just wait. Now it is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I am doing, that is, I am taking a list here. Okay. That is num11. Okay. It is an empty list. So I want to enter a number. Okay. I want to append the number. Okay. So and then I have also written here that is choice is a variable where I want to take and where I'm asking for to enter number as y or y. Okay, so if choice equal to uppercase y or choice equal to lowercase y, then break. Okay, so I'm running again this. Okay, done. So right now I want to do one thing. Just wait. I have to type first. Okay. We have learned this thing, but now I want to pass variable length arguments. Okay. I want to pass here. Suppose turn now. Okay. So then how can I pass arguments to my function sum underscore nums? So in such cases, what I can do, just look. Just I have to rerun the code. Okay, so what are you saying? What we are getting, that is the value of percent, the value of sum is 48, but I want to print it only once. Then what I can do, I have to return this. Okay. Just wait. Okay, done. Done up to that.
Ma'am, please define one more time, ma'am.
What are you saying?
Now one more time define this one.
Okay. Suppose what I have done. I have just used while loop. Okay, so you know while loop is used, while loop can be used when the number of iterations are not known in advance. Okay, so in such cases, what we can do, we can just we have taken here an empty list num 11. Okay, we just append the values by asking the user to provide the values. Okay, so then that values get appended to the empty list nums 11. Okay, and I have also introduced a condition, that is choice equal to whether you want to enter a number or not. Okay, in this condition, what I have mentioned, that is if choice equal to uppercase y or lowercase y, then I will come out of the loop. That is the num 11 list will get out of the loop. Okay, so that is, it will stop taking numbers, okay, from the user. In this way I have created a list. Suppose I run this again. And then I press Y. Okay, and then I want to print. Suppose I want to send below. I want to print num11 list. Okay, understood. These are the 5 items get appended. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
In earlier case, in print names, we have to provide the names through hard coding. George, Rick, Money, Brad. Okay. But I want to provide the names from the user. Okay. I want to provide the numbers in this case. Okay. So now in one case, I have shown you that sum underscore nums function does not receive any parameter. Okay. And you just, I'm doing the same again. You can either return the sum or you can print it out here. Okay. I'm just doing this. That is 12 plus 10 equal to 22 plus 8, 30 plus 11, 5 plus 6. Okay, so 41. Okay, but if I want to pass variable length number of arguments, if my function is receiving variable length numbers, okay, as here the asterisk sign is used for variable length. Okay, so nums is a parameter which can receive any number of values. So in such cases, how can I pass my argument to the sum underscore nums function? Okay, so it is your function sum underscore nums defined, that is def is stands for definition, you know, and then sum underscore nums receives one argument, that is, that takes variable length number of values, and then I have also defined sum equal to zero. Okay, this is a local variable to this function. Okay, then I iterate the items of num11 list. So num is used to iterate or loop through the items, and then it gets summed to the summed variable. Okay, so, and return summed. Okay, so after that, I am doing something, that is I want to create a loop which where I iterates over the items of list num11 and stores the result of the sum underscore nums function, which receives argument num11 dot index I. Index is used to retrieve the value of that particular position. Okay, so then it gets stored to the summed variable, and I want to print out the summed variable using print function. Understood?
Yes,
just wait. I have to do this. Understood? So one thing I want to show you here, suppose I just want to do one thing here. Okay. And I want to print this. Okay. But I want to change the values. Okay. I'm changing. Right now, num11 contains 5, 6, 8, 10, 12. But I want to change the value. Okay. But what happened? Just see. okay? So I'm rerunning now one more. And now I want to print this. Okay. Again. Okay. What now you are getting the submission as 75. Understood? When you are calling the function sum underscore nums. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, I'm rerunning the code. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the advantage of using, na? You can change the values, okay? But earlier you have to pass the values as hard coded, okay? In case of print underscore names, my underscore names, okay? Okay. So when you see such things where you need to pass arguments, then you have to do in this way, that is sum underscore nums passes argument num 11, which is the list dot index with the position I, okay? And if you don't want to pass anything, then you have to call the upper function, that is sum underscore nums, which receives no parameters. So sum underscore nums is called, has been sum underscore nums function has been called without any arguments, okay? Understood? Have you done this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so right now we want to do another thing, that is we want to return values based on condition checking, okay? Suppose if you want to know whether a year is a leap year and number of days present in a particular month, okay? Have you understood? Guys, please respond to me.
Ma'am, if you can explain it just with an overview.
Okay. Month underscore days is a list. Okay. I have started with the zero. Zero is used for as a placeholder for indexing purposes. Okay. Now I have written here, I have jotted down here two functions. One is for checking whether the year is a leap year or not. So is underscore leap receives year as parameter. Okay. So it will return based whether the year is leap year or not based on a condition. Year percent 4 equal to 0. You know that is 2004, 2008. These are the leap years. And checked what? That is within parentheses year percent 100 not equal to 0. Okay. That is suppose 1900.
And that part once again. And year what? Percent.
Yeah.
Then that part after and
after year, but I cannot get you.
Ma'am, can you explain that part after that?
Yes, and yes, you want to explain now. Just explain me.
No, ma'am. I want you to explain. I cannot understand that year percentage.
I cannot understand. Ma'am. What are you saying?
Ma'am, this part return year percentile 4, first equals 4 and year percentile 100.
Yes, just look at the output. When I am passing to 2017 as argument to the is underscore leap function, it returns boolean value false. Okay, it checks first, it checks what? 2017 percent 4. Okay, equal to 0, not. Then and it needs to satisfy both the condition. Year percent 4 equal to 0 and within parentheses either one of them. Either year percent 100 not equal to 0 or year percent 400 equal to 0. Understood? Suppose I am passing here. Okay, suppose yep, 1900 is divisible by 4. Okay, but 1900
90s is a leap year, na?
4.75. Okay. But 1900 divided by 100, 19. So here, this condition, either one of them needs to be true. Either you have to be year percent 100 not equal to 0 or year percent 400 equal to 0. Suppose if you pass 2000, then 2000% 400 equal to 0 condition gets satisfied. Understood? Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
What? What happened?
You can pass 1900. Is leap year. Output is false.
I have commented out two statements. Just go through. Okay. Suppose you have a list. Huh? That is that contains PQR, three elements. So suppose P is 1, say Q equal to 3, R equal to 4. So after applying map function, you want to add some value to it. Suppose P plus 3, Q plus 3, R plus 3. So function is applied to each element. Okay, F of P, F of Q, F of R respectively, and then form a new list. Okay. New list, now you can say a mapped object which can be typecasted to list or tuple. It depends on you. Okay. That is mapped object. Okay, so I want to get the values. Okay, so I just want to typecast. Understood? You can typecast it to tuple as well. Okay, just understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Here, after typecasting to tuple, when you are doing typecasting to list, then it gives you empty list, because then it operates on tuple of x. Okay. If I do this in this way, suppose, and then I apply tuple after operating list, okay, on x, then I will get an empty tuple. Okay, so either you have to do list of x or tuple of x. Okay, so that you can get the values. So here a is added to 3 each time. Okay, so A is an item, okay, present in the list. Okay, that is new underscore list. So 1 plus 3, 2 plus 3, 3 plus 3, 4 plus 3. Okay, and then the new list, 4, 5, 6, 7 printed out here. Okay. I can do this using lambda as well as map function is used for user defined function and lambda. Okay, lambda is what? Lambda is an anonymous function. It is a single statement where the return keyword is not used, but the value gets returned, which is used as input to some other function. Okay, so returning values are implicit here. Explicitly, return keyword is not used. Okay, that is, we cannot use return keyword explicitly. Understood? And then lambda is a single line statement. Okay, where the expression is evaluated along with the lambda definition. Okay. It takes no names. Lambda takes no names. No parentheses are required. Okay. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
I want to do one thing. Just understood, guys, please respond to me.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Here I have taken two lists: new underscore list, mod underscore list. You can take any number of iterables, okay? In case of map function, okay. So, just I want to multiply of the elements present in new underscore list and mod underscore list, okay? So I get the product and I convert it to list type. Okay, that is list of y1 gives you the product of the items present in new underscore list and mod underscore list. Okay, that is 1 into 4, 4. 5 into 2, 10. 3 into 6, 18. 4 into 7, 28. Okay, done up to that. Guys, done up to that?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Please, one more time, define 103 line.
What are you saying? I cannot get you.
Ma'am, one more time, define the lambda function p into q.
I cannot get you. Just be a little bit louder.
Ma'am, network problem. So, one more time, define the 103 line. Hello, ma'am.
Your voice is inaudible. I cannot get you.
Ma'am, he is saying that to repeat line number 103 once again.
Nothing comes. Pooja? Pooja? Can you understand what he is saying? Can anyone understand what he is saying? Just tell me. Hello. Hello, guys.
Ma'am, I can't understand what he is actually saying, what he is trying to say.
Yes, I cannot understand. He was inaudible. Okay, I'm continuing. Okay.
He's saying to make him understand the line number 103.
Okay, 103. Okay, map is a function, okay, where I have also passed lambda function. I have also used lambda function, which takes two parameters p, q, and it returns the value p multiplied by q, that is p times q. Okay, so how can I get this pq? I am receiving this pq from new underscore list and mod underscore list. Okay, so here the operation, that is product, gets returned to the map function. Okay, which does this operation on each element of new underscore list and mod underscore list. Okay, that is why, you know, mod underscore list contains 4 elements, 4, 5, 6, 7. New underscore list contains 4 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 into 4 is 4. 5 into 2, 10. 3 into 6, 18. 4 into 7, 28. Map returns a mapped object. Okay. If I want to retrieve the values, then I have to typecast. So I typecast it to list format. So I have used list over the list on Y1, and I get 4, 10, 18, 28 as a list. Okay, so thus the list prints out here. Okay, give me the product. Okay.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Because earlier I have said that is map function works on each element of a sequence. Okay, and provides a new list. This PQR will form a new mapped object after applying map function in the following way: f of p, f of q, f of r. Okay, that is lambda function p q. Okay, that returns p times q, operates on each element, that is 1 into 4, that is again 5 into 2. Okay, that's how lambda function operates, and it returns the result to the map object. Okay. And I want to get the value in list format. That's why I have typecasted to list. Okay. Okay. Suppose I want to do this. Mean is a system defined function. Okay, max is a system defined function. So I cannot use this in this way. If I want to create my own mean function, okay. then it gives you this error, mean take zero positional argument but one was given. Okay, that is mean of new list. But system defined mean means what? That is, how can I do this? Just wait. Suppose I want to show you in this way. Here I have defined now, so you know max, mean and liens, which stands for length, are built-in function. So when I have created mean function as user defined, so it takes one argument. Okay, suppose in case of max we are passing new underscore list. Okay, but now I have overwritten this, which takes zero. Okay, so in case of user defined mean, which takes zero parameter, so when I'm trying to pass this value, it gives me the error, mean takes zero positional argument but one was given. Okay, so we want to avoid, we cannot use these built-in functions here. In case of map, you have to use either lambda or user defined function. Okay, understood? Similarly, if I commented out all these things, and then I operate this, what happened? It takes the previous one, it holds the result, this definition. Okay, actually I have created the user defined main function, so it holds this one. Okay, so here I am just understand that max is not overwritten. Okay, max is not overwritten by the max built-in function. Okay, that's why it gives you the maximum value present in the new underscore list, that is 4. Okay, and new underscore list contains 1, 2, 3, 4. The maximum value is 4. Okay, I'm holding my cursor here, new underscore list. Okay, so I just want to show you that is max is not being overridden. Okay, and mean is being overridden by user defined function, so it gives you this error. Okay, understood? So we cannot use this type of things in case of map. You have to use user defined function or lambda function. Similarly, in case of reduce function, filter function, you have to use user defined function or anonymous lambda function. Okay. So now I am showing you how as to how we use filter function. Okay. Understood, guys? Filter function. I have introduced the condition checking.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it checks what? It checks whether the value of x greater or equal to 4. That gets printed out. Okay, so filter just discards few elements based on a condition checking. Okay, that is. I'm just commenting out list p comma q comma r. Okay, understood. Now I want to show you the use of reduce function. Okay, I have to import this reduce. Okay, so mainly I think it is present in collections package. Just hold. Just wait.
Ma'am, your screen is not visible. Ma'am, is there any net issue?
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, now it is visible.
Oh, sorry. Okay. So here what happens? Suppose it is your list T, comma Q, comma R, comma S, comma T. So what happened first? Reduce function is applied on list PQRST. Okay. So then what happened? This reduce function just do one thing. That is, suppose this is your function. Okay. And this is another function which operates on the first two elements P, comma Q, and then the resultant and the next element will be treated by the function. Okay, understood? That is first X and Y. Okay, that is my first two elements are 1 and 2. They are added. They get added. That is 1 plus 2 equal to 3. Then 3 comma 4. Okay, these two items get added. Okay, so it will give you 7. Then 7 comma 4. That two items get added. Then 11 plus 7 plus 4 equal to 11. 11 plus 5 equal to 16. Okay, so in this way we move on. Okay, so here what happened, that is 2 plus 1 3, 3 plus 3 6, 6 plus 4 your 10, 10 plus 5 15, 15 plus 6 21. Okay, so reduce function operates on each element and it first computes or does any operation mentioned in the lambda function or user defined function on the two of on the very first two elements, and then the resultant gets computed with the third element and so on, and finally the resultant gives a single value. Okay, that is either summation or product, or that is a single value gets returned here. Okay, understood? Guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you done up to that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. have any idea regarding generator?
Ma'am, no.
Okay. I'm just showing you one thing, okay? What happened? This I get stuck here. Oh, it's wet. I'm just guys, I just need to restart my kernel, okay? I need to restart, huh? Happened. Guys, look at the output, okay? You know how to define a function, okay? But if I want to do the same using generator, and there are some advantages of using generator over using function, okay? Guys, respond to me.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you done this on your Jupyter notebook?
Yes, ma'am. Up to this, I'm writing in a copy, ma'am. And up to this, I have copied.
Okay. Okay. So yield is a keyword, okay? So yield is a keyword, and it does not hold any value in the memory, okay? Suppose you want to print this my square, suppose. Just wait. You get a generator object here, okay? So in this case, you have to get the values using list function. List is used to typecast. Okay. Okay, so what happened in this case, generator, in case of using generator, I don't want to return anything. I just use yield. Okay, yield keyword gives a generator object that does not hold any value at a time in the memory location. Okay, what happened here, you have to retrieve each value, okay, either using next command on my generator square, or you have to create a loop which iterates over the my gen square, and or you have to pass this my gen square to a list to retrieve the values of the squared numbers. Okay, so just I'm showing you this thing again, this, and now I want to insert a cell below here. Okay, if I do this next, it will give you first value. Then if I print this few times, okay, just wait to again run this. Okay, this is and when the generator is out of values, it throws an error that is stop iteration. Okay, that is the generator has been exhausted here. Guys, understood up to that part?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Guys, we have done a function, user-defined function. Now, in case of user-defined function, you know how to pass arguments and how to execute the function and how to define function where the function performs some particular task and returns value or prints out something. Okay, so if I want to do the same operation using generator concept, so what will be my advantage here? I have used yield keyword, okay, which generates a generator object that is my underscore gen underscore square, okay, equal to my function is RDS press underscore gen underscore square, which receives a list of four items. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively. Then I just want to print my gen square out here, which gives me a generator object. It does not hold any item in memory location. Okay, so my memory is free. So how can I get the values? I have to print either next command to, that is I have to use next to my gen square generator object and then get the squared numbers. Okay, that is 1, 4, 9, 16. Okay, then if I iterate for the next iteration, it gives me stop iteration. It throws an error that is stop iteration because the generator has been exhausted here. So what I want to say you, that is, what is the use? In case of list, you want to store the values. That is the number of squared values in memory. Okay, but here the generator does not hold any item in memory. So it is, your memory is free to use for other purpose. Okay, when you want to get the values, you just create a loop which iterates over the items of the generator, okay? Or you have to use the next format. Suppose I want to, you can use list or tuple, which can cast the my generator square object to this list format. Suppose I want to use for loop. Just wait. Okay. Understood.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is how I can use. So I want to cite one another example, then you can use. Then you can see the difference of using this and the advantage of using generator over functions, because here you cannot understand, because you think there are only four items, so memory usage of memory does not matter. But in case of such values where millions of values need to be stored, and so a lot of space gets occupied, okay? So to avoid occupying those spaces and just to keep your memory resources free, then you need to use generator. I'm showing you one example. Okay, one thing I want to show you, just wait. You know least comprehension? I'm doing this, just watch. We can do the same for generator. Here you need to use parentheses instead of square brackets. Okay, x times x within parentheses. Okay. Okay, So this is your generator object. Okay, then you can print it either type casting to list or for using for loop or using next. Guys, you all are following me now?
Yes, ma'am.
Do the same on your Jupyter notebook, okay? Then I will explain you.
Ma'am, I am writing on my copy, and since I from the beginning I am writing in my copy, so in this way I am taking all the notes actually.
What about the rest ones?
Writing on Jupyter. Ma'am, my audio.
Guys, you all are doing.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Just I want to exhibit this. Just wait. Just wait. Just wait.
Hello.
Hello.
Are you wrap up the session?
No, just wait 5 minutes.
Okay, no problem.
I have to install memory profiler first, okay? Then I have to do this. Because it is not, the module is not installed in my Anaconda, okay?
So ma'am, can you do it in the next class?
Okay, I will do it in the next class, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
That will be good. Because now I need some time. Okay.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Otherwise, it will become very lengthy.
Yes. I will discuss this in the next session. Okay. So I'm
leaving
here. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. So we can end the session, right?
Yes.